right, we'll start the meeting with a pledge allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Welcome to the South Burlington School Board meeting. And I'll start with any comments from the public regarding items that are not on the agenda. All right, seeing none, do we have amendments, David, to the agenda?
We do not. The only thing we are going to add is a executive session to the end.
Okay. All right, so we'll add a brief executive session at the end of regular meeting?
Yes, it's a continuation of item B on executive session, legal matter, legal services discussion.
Okay. Great. All right. So we'll move on to announcements.
So a lot going on in this school. Some of you probably smell some paint. You see, if you've been over to the high school, although you can't really get in there very well, there's a lot going on. A couple of quick things. The farmer's market, as you last heard, actually was at this location. But they have since made a decision to move to the University Mall to have more traffic and to be able to do that. Again, they were happy to be here. Obviously, it's not connected to the rate. At least I don't believe so, because we made those changes. But just wanted to let the board know. Also, I wanted to ask John just to comment a little bit on, we did receive a grant from Common Roots, $20,000, for the purposes of supporting nutrition services, et cetera. But John, anything else to add to?
Well, it's primarily for chef training, but the nutritional services director has some discretion to use if we have equipment needs and that kind of thing. So we're very thankful for that.
This is a new one, John?
Yes. And Kendall Loomis, who was here, made the presentation a month ago, wanted me to emphasize that the move was not even a thought about when she came. It wasn't disingenuous. So she just wanted you to know that.
And then the last thing, actually, by your side is a letter from the state of Vermont on the governor's award. And so, again, we continue, as a result of a lot of the positive work that's happening within your district with schools and making upgrades, whether they're lighting upgrades or, insulation upgrades, et cetera, control upgrades. We've been recognized, all five schools, and this is consistent with what you had before. This is fairly recent, though, so we're in this kind of being recognized in this capacity. We will be in attendance. If any of you would like to go, that's certainly up to you. I have some administrators down there, and we'll have that covered, so that award will be received. But again, a lot of it, as it says, talks about pollution, environmental protection, et cetera, et cetera. So other than that, a lot going on. Fox 44 was here. You probably got that brief little email. If you saw your email, they were here. They wanted to be here yesterday afternoon, but we said, if you certainly come back. And John and I met with them. We did share some pictures of things were going on. John did a nice job having that ready. And then we took them on a visit also, John did, over at the high school. So kind of telling the story about some of the work that's happening, highlighting the stewardship plan and the work that the board has instilled in helping to keep our district a good place. So don't know when that aired. I don't know if it's aired yet. We don't know. So anyway, that's all I have.
As I drive by schools in Chittenden County, I see a lot of construction mm-hmm. going on.
Yes, for sure.
Yeah. Good. All right, any other announcements from board members? All right, we'll move on to agenda item 6, master planning, financial stewardship, and city and school collaboration.
So I have been working, as I indicated last time, we're yet to receive the kind of final report from the master planning and visioning. We think that that's soon to come. Not a lot to change, just going to be more conclusive. I've been working, and I didn't make copies of this, but I've been working with the city on identifying some of the key capital improvement activities to get that down on paper with completion dates, so that then I'm populating what I'm going to say to provide the board with some sequence steps using both suggested options that were received from the task force, that are looking at city capital improvement considerations. So I'm not sure that I got the right thing going here, but I'm trying to provide you with, you know, some sequencing based on all schools, district, and the considerations. So I'm working through that, that you'll then be able to have. Elizabeth and I are, we have another city meeting coming up next week with Pat Nowak and Kevin. This is certainly a conversation for us. We also have some other things that are going on to try to help me to look at providing you with the most delineated information that I can provide you around the options. So that's master planning and visioning.
So the is it a calendar you're putting together?
Well, it's, you know, what they have in the capital improvement plan is looking at things like, you know, City Center Park, and they have scoping, planning, and design, mm-hmm. and then they actually have construction, or what they're calling potential construction. So I think that's really important when we do scoping, planning, design, and voters. Mm-hmm. I feel like we need to be sequenced in there appropriately, or they need to be sequenced
with
us.
So we're looking to put the project work plan married up with the city
activities.
Correct.
Okay. Yeah. So although you can't see it well, but these are just highlighted in different colors. And then my plan is to try to pull down some of the city, our work, in concert with some of the, you know, the upcoming activities that are going on or being proposed to go on with the city. So I don't want to be extremely complex with this because we have a need, but we do not want to be absent of some of the things that are going on for the city. At the same time, we're trying to do some pretty big things here as well. So, and being able to communicate that with clarity to the community will be really important.
Any questions, comments on master planning agenda item? Do we have a target date of the end of the month to get the task force final report?
Correct.
Accurate?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So will we have the meeting in late August? Will we get a chance to really delve into this more deeply?
I mean, that would be my plan. That, I mean, and this is, it's important to you know, move on in sequence, and you may direct me once you see it to recalibrate or whatever you want to call it, you know, or challenge me on some. I do plan to look at those two options and then all of the other things that are currently going on and see how I can provide you with some sequencing, information, ideas, et cetera.
And it looks like the next regular session we have is August 19th.
Right.
Is that
mm-hmm.
accurate?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
We also have on the agenda a work session.
Yeah.
And so that also could be the 3-hour work session could
so
be dedicated.
So will you send out the final task force report to us electronically when you get it?
Yeah, sure will.
All right.
Do you have a question? I'm sorry, before we switch topics there.
Sure.
It's my understanding that the task force is putting forward two options to the voters. Well, to you, and then ultimately the voters. And from the beginning, I've been asking for more than two options, because I don't believe that either of those two fully represent all of our options. So I'm hoping that there's going to be another option presented. Can you speak to that at all? Who do we speak to about that? I feel like already by the time it gets out of the gate, it's already channeled and limited.
Yeah, I'll open it up to the rest of the board, but the task force will present the options that they've discussed. There'll be, as far as the board considerations, we're really going to be developing our own work plan to look at whether those are options, both, neither, or one that we would want to take forward and get additional community feedback on and or take to a vote. So, I mean, that's all I can really say definitively now is I wouldn't lock in anything necessarily, because the board's work is really just starting based on the task force recommendations. And does anybody want to add comments to that?
Yeah, I guess I'd add, I mean, if for this kind of decision, you know, we've asked this task force to really evaluate a lot of information mm-hmm. for us and give us their best idea. We do not have to defer to them. I mean, if we had, you know, there's certain decisions that we get from the administration that we give a lot of deference. And unless it's an irrational move that the administration wants us to make, you know, we will approve it. That's just the way it works. This is a decision that's really the board's decision, and we have asked the task force to give us information to help us in that decision. So, yeah, I mean, it's going to get some weight because they put a lot of time into it, but we're going to scrutinize it very carefully and this issue very carefully and get more public input as well. So,
I understand that. I mean, I know you've said that before. However, I know that there's part of the work of the task force has sort of been, I wouldn't say marginalized perhaps, but from what I understand, maybe minimized. So I think it's important to just have them be as open with their presentation to you as they could be. If you could maybe ask them for more if you're feeling like that.
Well, we did.
You know what I'm saying?
I mean, the task force as an entity has really concluded their work. But what the board will do at this point is sort of take the report and marry it up with the recommendations on additional. There were several, as you recall, Kathy, several recommendations for additional, I'll call it committees, and that may or may not be the best way to pursue additional information, but there were recommendations for additional information that would inform a decision, as well as community feedback. So I think there will be a lot of opportunity for further discussion on the options. But like Martin said, you know, the task force spent a lot of time evaluating options. What the board hasn't done is really weigh in on kind of the guardrails of what is the community willing to invest in terms of the future of delivery of public education in South Burlington, and balance that with what the community can afford. So there will be some guardrails that will come up in our discussion that weren't necessarily limitations within the task force.
Okay.
I don't know if that answers your question, but I understand what you're saying.
I know you do. Okay.
Yeah, if there are other proposals, I think they have to come forward. Yeah. I think we're still looking for validation as to what provides the best education for students, the safest environment for them to do that in, and provides us a very efficient way of getting it done, both from a staffing and financial standpoint.
Yeah, and I think the ultimate test would be if the board elected to take one option to the community vis-a-vis a ballot item, if it's voted down, that's a clear indication. But our hope is obviously that there's an educational process that will go along with that. So I'll leave it at that.
So the report is due out, is going to be made available to the board and to the public. Consideration about a survey, and the continuation of the board that continues to be open to receive, as Dan said, you know, information. And I think that's going to be important as that report is heard, and talking about the report and looking at the options and providing ideas is open, appropriate, and wanted. This is we're in a very complicated place. But we're all trying, I think the board, on behalf of the board, they're certainly trying to do the right thing, not just now, but into the future. We've been very fortunate to have a lot of committed community members giving us considerable amount of time to the work. So we got a long ways to go, but there's been progress. So.
Good. All right. Any other comments, questions? All right, we'll move on to agenda item 7, staffing and information table at City Fest.
So I haven't done anything for you in preparation. I know that there were some ideas around what you might want. I think you can't be overzealous around what you can probably provide, and you know, someone's going to stop by and you're going to get them for 2, 3, 4 minutes. These are lessons I've learned. So I don't know exactly what you might, if you want sandwich board type thing, you let me know. I'm not sure. We can do some master planning and some bullet points. We could do, you know, information about kind of school configuration or school choice. You could highlight some things that are easy and not
well,
as.
I guess first off, we did commit to
yes.
the space.
Yep.
Okay.
Yep.
I know one thing we had talked about was having a map that would show I mean, the current location of schools, but also the concentration of students.
Mm-hmm.
I think we have something.
We have it. Yes, we do.
Is that something that could be fairly large on a easel or something?
Mm-hmm.
Is there agreement that that would be one good piece of information?
Yeah, I mean, I would suggest that we don't want too much, because I think we want to leave space open for that, so that the public can walk by and talk to us about anything. I don't think we want to set up so much about physical plant that that's all people think they are there to talk to us about. I think we want to be pretty open about any education-related topics.
So it could be a map in South Burlington's school district, you know, board, you know, something that attracts them there, and then open up the conversation and having you ready with some information to
some half-sized cards, you know, what are your, the prompt thoughts that they could leave behind, too, if they wanted to. If they didn't want to talk to somebody, they just want to write a note. You know, this is what I think is important in South Burlington for education. If they don't want to talk to somebody, just, you know, various ways of getting feedback in that space.
Is there more specific feedback we'd want to solicit as a board versus open-ended? I mean, knowing some of the I'm thinking ahead to a lot of the time the board will spend. It will be around master planning and visioning. It'll be on 21st century learning. It will be on individual
personalized learning.
Yeah, it will
efficiency be efficiency-based.
Yeah. It could be on legislative issues. It could be, I mean, there's a host of of issues that we could solicit feedback. Do we want to target that? Or maybe even have a prompt list, or I'm just
trying to. Prompt list would be a good idea. I like that. On a big sheet, you know, the various big topics that we know we're going to be tackling over the next couple of years, just as, even if they don't know, if they're not really engaged now, maybe some of those prompt words will say, well, what is that? And then we can start a conversation. It might also not be a bad idea to publish and have available copies of when we meet as and where we meet, so that people might be able to take that with them.
So maybe a board schedule, and maybe if we had one easel with just sort of who we serve, as that we can call it that, and where we are, and then maybe the other one is just a list of prompt topics. Then,
yeah, it's a good idea.
I like the idea of the cards too. If people don't want to engage in a conversation, we can at least get some written comments.
Yep.
So maybe you could solicit David by email what the prompt topics would be.
Mm-hmm. And as far as who's planning on being there, I know it is
what's our date
a
again?
Bit. It's August.
Is it all day?
It starts at 2?
Mm-hmm.
It's my memory anyway.
Yeah, and they when I talked to the individual that was setting it up, tables could be staffed as late as 9, I think, but I think there's an expectation that they wouldn't have to be staffed the whole time.
Right. Are we going to have Rhonda get us some nutritious snacks to pass out?
Well, we can take care of the snacks. We can make sure you're...
Well, not for us, for, you know, for the people.
Oh, so something that's enticing with...
Entice them in, yeah.
We're not in the nutritional services business.
Well, we have a whole company doing it for us, right? Internal.
So why not... I know not everyone was able to be there or short chunks of time, so maybe we will define the time blocks. And see
it
how
might
we
be good to validate with them. Is it
John?
What time frame they want the table staffed? Butcher.
I think they said. My memory was that they wanted it staffed at least from 2 to 5 or 6.
And that's kind of what I recall too. Yeah.
Discretionary staffing.
Yeah.
Is the council having a table?
Don't know. I'm not. I haven't asked. I can find out and just let you know. I was just thinking we can do kind of an hour by hour and just we'll populate it with, you know, some of this information and sandwich boards, and whoever is able to then sign up, I think maybe just go back to those folks who are able to be there and make sure you're feeling comfortable with, you know, what
so maybe
what's
if
available.
We could do a couple people so overlap a little bit.
Yeah.
Good. What's the date?
August
15th.
I won't be able to be there.
Yeah.
I'm not going to be there either.
Oh, no.
I'll probably be there all day, pressing the flesh.
Okay, that would be good.
So no Julie and no...
And I have to say mine's a little open-ended, too, so...
Yeah, no problem.
I plan to be right now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I could do whatever time frame works.
Yeah, okay.
So can I.
Okay.
Great, thanks.
All right, that sounds good. All right, we'll move on to agenda item 8, proposal to purchase Rick Marcot Central School discussion. Do you want me to preface this a little bit, David?
Sure.
I think you all recall that in late May or June of last year, at a city school steering committee, Saxon Partners made a verbal proposal about acquiring Rick Marcot Central School. Subsequently, in June of 2014, David, as superintendent, received a letter on the school board's behalf outlining quite a bit of detail on Gene Bowden's involvement in the form-based code committee meetings and so forth, and the specific language in the letter that went to David and subsequently to the board was that there was an interest in discussing with the school committee whether there would be any interest in selling the Marcot School property so that we could include it in the city center master plan as described above, which is in the heart of the letter, based on our understanding of some of the area infrastructure that is to be completed under the TIF program. We are offering $7 million for the Central School property. Ideally, we would like to acquire the school property at the end of the school year in 2016. And I know that we haven't actually received the final report of the task force yet. The intent of the board is to really take the task force work, turn that into a work plan on behalf of the board that may include any or all of the subcommittees that were recommended by the task force, and to really solicit community feedback in the form of not only a survey but potentially other venues on a going forward basis, really on everything from configuration of schools to delivery of public education in South Burlington to whether or not the sale of a specific school property might be taken to the voters at some point in the future. Might also include an RFP process. But I think the general outcome of the task force was that though there may be a specific recommendation around school configurations, the work of the board hasn't really begun yet. So the opportunity to really engage in an exclusive dialogue with an individual developer at this time is really inconsistent with the work we have in front of us. So I wanted to just put that out there. I know there's been some discussion in public sessions about a specific offer or proposal, and that, for those of you who are observing, that was the extent of the proposal that was made. I also would acknowledge it's come up in the past, I think at the last task force presentation, that kind of which came first, the school board consideration of school configuration options or the specific proposal to acquire the Rick Marcot Central School property. And having served on the board for over 10 years, I would say we did have a strategic plan that was being in the process of administrative review. And I will acknowledge that the specific proposal has accelerated work that the board had intended to engage the community in all along. I'll leave it at that. But I wanted to really just use this agenda item to open up a discussion about this specific item. So let me stop there and get comments from my colleagues.
I'll start. I think coming to a decision point by year end, by fiscal year end 16 is unrealistic. It's just premature given the status of where we are and the fact that we do need to go through at least some significantly more engagement with the community about are these task force recommendations the right thing? Are there others that ought to be considered? Are they well-founded? And do all the diligence in that regard. So I think that's going to take preponderance of that amount of time anyway. I think, and then just on a fundamental basis, I think that it would be inappropriate for us under any circumstances to declare, certainly at this point in time, an exclusive relationship with anybody to develop this property. So I think it's appropriate for us to make it clear to Saxon Partners and others that this is not the right time and we won't do it this way, okay? It'll be another process that'll go through to determine what the options really are.
Okay. Other comments?
Well, in the spirit of moving us along, I'll observe that I agree with both sentiments that you both made. I think we need more community engagement before we make a decision. The timeline is still to be kind of laid out in front of us. We don't know what that is yet, and it would be premature to obviously move forward in any particular offer at this point. So I think that we don't know how we're going to end on this, so I think all the options are open as far as I'm concerned, but we don't know enough, even though we've got a ton of information from the task force. We don't know enough yet to take action yet, so
I think some of, yeah, if I could add, too, I think some of the information that has been identified through the task force is also, I think, no one on the board, I think, has been involved in any discussion of community-owned property. So we do have an obligation to taxpayers to really evaluate all the options that might be available and whether the community would direct the board, or we would make a recommendation to the community, whether to optimize the value of a sale or to potentially look at some other configuration that might be valued by the community beyond an absolute dollar amount. But what we also was new information that the task force identified, or maybe administration identified in the late stages of the task force work, was what the obligation was to pay back for state-funded projects. So there is some debt burden that the district and the community has relative to each of the facilities that are currently within the district. And I know that's opened up the opportunity to really discuss even potentially a legislative solution to improve or to acknowledge intra-district consolidation the way that the Act 46 is acknowledging supervisory union and consolidation between districts or supervisory unions in the state.
Mm-hmm.
Other comments or observations?
Yeah, I think this off the so-called offer that's out there has clouded what we've been trying to do to some extent. And just reiterating somewhat what you're saying is our first decision, although it's perhaps been accelerated, is what is the best configuration, what is the best outcome for the education going forward in South Burlington. There is a second issue, and you alluded to that you know, if we decide that selling Central School is consistent with our education mission, and either it's a wash or we'll improve the situation, you know, then this, the next question of, well, this is community property, what should be done with the community property? So I think kind of clearing that, putting it to the side. And that doesn't mean that down the road that the same developers cannot make a proposal if we ultimately decide to sell the, or to ask the community to sell the property. So,
Kathy?
A quick question, Elizabeth, as to what you were saying. Are you saying that because of the district consolidation, you're hoping that the state would eliminate the fee that we would be charged should we resell the building?
No, we've identified in the process of the task force work that each of our facilities did basically borrow some state money to make improvements on each of the facilities that right now we would be obligated to pay back.
Right.
So there's a burden across each of the facilities at a different amount based on decisions that might be made. If the community, for instance, supported the sale of Rick Marcotte Central, it's about $2 million, I think.
It varies.
The max is 2.7.
Yeah, 2.7 million would be owed to the state right now. The state just passed legislation in the last session that really is incenting districts to look at consolidating and providing some of those financial incentives, but the legislature never looked at intra-district consolidation, and one of the potential incentives might be to eliminate the debt burden associated with a past development.
Okay, thanks for that clarification.
No problem.
Okay.
Any other comments or questions? So maybe I can summarize and just anybody speak up if this is inconsistent, but perhaps I think it is the consensus of the board that we maybe should direct David to get back to Saxon Partners and just indicate that we haven't established a work plan yet, that an RFP that might look at the sale of a school property may be considered in the future, and that we would respectfully encourage Saxon and other developers and other potential acquirers to participate in that process should it occur. But at this point in time, that we are not going to pursue any exclusive conversations or considerations about the sale of Rick Marcotte Central. Is that the general sentiment of the board?
Yes.
Yep.
So David, can we direct you to respond to that? And could I also, if it's the will of the board, perhaps just out of courtesy, we could get in touch with Kevin Dorn and Pat Nowak as well?
Okay.
All right, any other questions or comments on agenda item 8? We'll move on to agenda item 9, the superintendent's report.
I have one item, the letter that we received from Grand Isle, specific to wanting to connect with us regarding what you were just talking about, Elizabeth, around the recent law passage, Act 46, which was known throughout the time in the legislature as H-361. To pursue opportunities to designate up to 3 receiving high schools for Grand Isle students. They list a whole series of things that they'd like to talk about. We can talk a little bit more about any reservations, concerns, or questions, but I have responded to this. I have a meeting set up with Elizabeth and myself to at least begin the process, meeting with Barbara Burlington, who's the new superintendent, and Gary Marquis. I think I'm saying his last name right, but he's the chair of the Grand Isle board. That's where we are to date. Again, this would be just simply to open up conversation and understand a little bit more about their wants and needs, and also our services really to date, you know, with serving them.
The letter seems to request a fairly comprehensive presentation by interested parties by no later than October 1st. So is this discussions you're talking about sort of a preamble to the possibility that the district might do something like that?
Yeah. So a couple things. We had reached out to them prior. We had before the superintendent, the previous superintendent, Bob Phillips, left. And so this meeting desire is actually was almost set up before the receipt of the letter. I think the conversation, I can't speak specifically to the accuracy of this, but a lot of the conversation that we had previously and me with the chair of their board was really about setting up a conduit for communication. The letter then has come, and again, we're folding those together. At this point, we are not prepared to go in and do, a presentation. It's really kind of a relationship connection and understanding of also where we are and what we're working on. I think that's really important for us to share with them. Mm-hmm. Some of the conversations that were just being shared tonight will be important to them around kind of the due diligence that the South Burlington School Board is putting forward.
I just want to point out that they're really explicit about when they want the information. So
mm-hmm.
I think a lot of this information, don't we have a lot of this information with Debbie Beretta's kind of show on the road and stuff like that?
We do, and remember, this is not just to us, so this is what I will say. I know it's gone to other districts, and so again, it's trying to make sure that apples and apples are shared. Certainly, because a lot of students come to us, there's absolutely already knowledge of what we do or what we're doing and or what we're improving. Right. And a lot of, as you said, Julie, we do have efforts that work to connect and inform students and parents about what we have already. And in some cases, the board members may not necessarily know that.
Mm-hmm.
So that meeting's coming up August 18th at 8 o'clock, and we're going to be here. They're coming to us. And 8 in the morning.
All right, any other questions on that? All right, we'll move on to agenda item 10, executive limitations policy monitoring, 2.3, treatment of community.
I'm just slowing up right now.
I got to put the time delay on.
Yeah, exactly. I apologize. It's only somewhat related to this issue, and I just was wondering about if there's any planned follow-up yet related to the broader ideas under Act 46 as far as discussing possibilities of doing something more than just being the designated, one of three designated high schools. But I think we've talked about wanting to do some outreach to surrounding districts, including Grand Isle, Isle Lamont, Georgia, et cetera. It could even go broader than that to see if there are any opportunities for something more closer collaboration between the districts.
Yeah. So again, the Grand Isle was the first step, and there's been some changes in leadership, but I'm planning on going out, I would say in a more personal way, just connecting with them. Again, there was recent information from the VSA looking at supporting and or wondering who's interested, wanting to pursue more of the opportunities under A46. So that actually just came out. That was something that I was trying to encourage. So I'm not the only one going out, but who are in places of interest, to at least open to conversation. So I'm anxious to get that back. That, however, doesn't mean that we can't reach out to, you know, those that surround us that we know are within reasonable distance, we'll say, that we could collaborate with.
Yeah, I wonder, to Martin's point, you interface with your peer group of superintendents on a routine basis. It's less routine for board members and superintendents to kind of go out collaboratively. I wonder if we shouldn't come up with kind of a list of where we'd want to reach out to both board representation and district leadership at the same time.
I'm fine to do that. I'll probably have a little bit more information on those that are interested, and a follow-up to our meeting. I could engage with you a little bit on trying to find some other dates and times where we could go do that.
Yeah, I know I'm looking forward to the Grand Isle one, just to hear what is of interest to other districts. So I think that could inform our outreach process as well.
Right. I mean, it's just, for instance, district where we are receiving a lot of the students in high school, they've gone through a different elementary school curriculum, possibly, and middle school. And I know that increasingly how we conduct business is it's a K through 12 step-by-step process. And if there's a way that we could be mirrored a little bit better with the elementary and middle schools of our sending schools, who are sending high schoolers, and that should be part of that broader conversation, I would think.
Curriculum alignment, you know, that Martin brings up is an important one, although it will become more and more close as we look to implement some of these things that are upon us. That said, it is disparate. It's different, you know, for our kids that come from our system and then feed in. And I'm not saying that's good or bad, but it's inconsistent in some cases. And we have worked to reach out to some of our senders to make sure we're understanding of some of the articulation, but in no way are we doing it anywhere near enough. So it's always good. I like the ideas, and we'll keep working at it.
Okay. All right. Now we'll move on to 2.3, treatment of community.
So it's in your packet, highlighted in yellow are, you know, the changes. I do want to, right out of the gate, highlight on page 2 of 3, completing the surveys. I don't feel like that's totally accurate. I'm going to need to rework that a little bit. So
where are you, David?
It's just after halfway, after an input into school matters.
Mm-hmm.
It's the second paragraph. I'm not feeling totally okay with that, and I need to rework that to be a little bit more accurate. So I'm already asking for a little change on that. But
Are we going to go through this? Is that what we're
doing? Whatever you so desire, I can make that change, bring it back. You can review it Again, the highlighted yellow are just the areas of change.
Yeah, I do have one other question. So at the top of that page, it says the mentor program is expanding. Didn't they already do that this past year to Tuttle?
No, it's expanding though into the high school.
Oh.
So that's...
But that it says that it's expanding at Tuttle.
Yeah.
Next should, year. And I think that already happened, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
The one comment I have is this is intended to be a monitoring report, so anywhere that references information that hasn't been completed, like in that paragraph you mentioned,
mm-hmm.
it said data from surveys on the climate survey will be used.
Mm-hmm.
shouldn't this be, this is kind of historical reporting, so.
Have been used.
Or it would even be referenced as maybe an exhibit.
Mm-hmm.
Of surveys that you need to get back in order to sort of quantify the survey?
We haven't necessarily gotten into that, Kathy. I mean, when we get feedback, we value the feedback. Obviously, if it's only one, then, you know, it's we would probably not be including that. We want to get pretty positive response. So that's pretty vague.
Well, this one is high school driven, so I'm not sure if there is a target on that.
And from my perspective as somebody who likes to give feedback, I find the surveys really very difficult to complete and frustrating. Mm. And I don't think they ask anything that I feel like sharing. So I there were a couple that we received the past couple of years, and I think I quit halfway in the middle. I think there was redundancy, and it was sort of kind of convoluted, and honestly I thought it was a meaningless sort of survey. I don't know who puts them together, but I don't know if you know what you're trying to get out of them or whatever. Just consider that maybe.
Well, I do think one of the goals of this particular treatment of community is for the district to demonstrate how it has utilized feedback from the community. So that's what we'll really look for in an effective monitoring report is, you've referenced surveys a couple of times here in suggestion box, but it will be how is the information being used.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I guess, I mean, that potentially brings up what Kathy is suggesting and what she is talking about. It brings up an issue of, I mean, how much do we have to understand the underlying evidence to make sure that we agree? I mean, if I'm hearing from Kathy saying that this community feedback is a hoax, you know, or the climate feedback only five people are actually responding because it's for the reasons Kathy has said, I mean, that's a problem. So I think that we need to delve in or get a little bit more evidence from David that there was a 70% response rate or something, and only Kathy was annoyed. But I mean, I think we need a little more evidence just because that has now been brought up as a possibility. I'm just saying we have a climate feedback. I don't know if that...
Participation and resolved actions
would be great.
You know, one thing we had talked about quite a while ago, and I don't want to limit this to surveys specifically, but this is... the monitoring report that looks at recognizing that community members are owners of the school programs mm-hmm. and facilities. So there is a strong element of feedback as to how we're doing on that. I know at one point we discussed having some kind of a master calendar of surveys that were going out, so we weren't having survey fatigue either within a specific school or program or facility or program or parent group or student group for that matter. So I don't know if we've had any
progress there. We have that. I haven't provided it to you. So,
so maybe that would be evidence as well.
Yeah. And we've done a better job. I'm not wanting to say a great job yet, but we've done a better job in looking at when we do them, the frequency of we're doing them, whom they're going to, so that we're not bombarding, you know, people. I think redundancy probably is a good piece. So
I didn't mean the redundancy. I I mean, the amount of surveys, that's not a problem for me.
The questions.
I just think within the survey, I think the surveys came across from a an administrator perspective, perhaps. You know what I'm saying? It wasn't perhaps directed toward parents who are filling out. Does
gotcha.
That make sense?
Mm-hmm.
I think it, mm-hmm. yes.
Okay.
That's all.
So it sounds like one of the consistent pieces of feedback is really evidence on
mm-hmm.
this and then outcomes. Any other?
I also think that since the main thrust of this is connecting with the community, I think that somewhere in here we need to talk about how we keep the community informed about the results that we're getting and how their money's being spent, kind of the bang for the buck. And I didn't see that in here anywhere. I mean, and I know there's the suggestion box, but I mean, what I'm talking about really is not so much feedback in the form of complaints, but, you know, how do we get the word out that you're getting a good value?
Well, I think, yeah, I mean, not to, I don't want to speak for David, but in evidence using the report card, but, you know, all of, as I think about it, all of the work that's been done on voter participation, this would be good evidence, and our efforts to engage voters in the budgeting process at a minimum.
Yeah, I mean, I think we've done it. I just don't see it here articulated.
Yeah, I got you. I think there's a lot that can be added here, and it's probably a list that's not complete ever. You know, I think about your meetings. These are meetings, and our ATNs, and ways in which people can listen, be informed, and or respond, whether they can sit here or not. Participation, you know, in board meetings or other open
the task force,
right? So, you know, when you look at, you know, there's the community meetings that we sometimes have that are largely attended. So what's hard for me is, you know, there's always more. And
right.
again, that's us included, is how do we do that? So I get it. I can do a little bit more on this and bring it back.
So unless there's other questions, we'll ask David to kind of revisit this one and bring it back in front of the board.
Yeah, it is on our next agenda too. So, yeah.
All right.
Thank you.
All right, so we'll move on to agenda item 11, 4.2 board job description. And this is continued from our last meeting. I think, David, you provided some additional.
I did. I'm going to tell you, I didn't go like crazy and rewriting anything. I went to some other policy governance districts and, you know, that do the same job you guys are doing, and just pulled from that. So just to give you an idea and a flavor of what others are doing, so you can compare it as a place to start.
Given the content of what came in some of those other things, it got me to thinking that the board really does a lot more things that we ought to consider are part of our job or not part of our job. And if they are, put them in the job description. And I think that my suggestion is that rather than try to hammer that out in an open session like this, that a couple of us go off and try to draft a proposal that's a little more comprehensive based on our own knowledge of what goes on and the information you provided us as a next pass at this. I mean, it wouldn't be the final thing, but it would be hopefully. I just don't think this is the right. I think the scope is big enough for the change that I have in mind, that if that's the direction we want to go, and I'd rather that we did this as a subcommittee than as a group process, as a suggestion.
And do we have, I know under this agenda item, we have a special board work meeting. Is that scheduled?
Not yet.
So if the board is in agreement, we could ask the subcommittee to kind of report out at that working session where there's a little more ample time to have discussion.
That could work.
Does that make sense? Mm-hmm. So, Dan, am I interpreting your interest in being at least?
I'd be very happy to participate. I do have some constraints on my availability over the next month, but yes, okay. I'd be very happy to participate.
Do we have another volunteer?
I volunteer.
Okay.
I'd just like to make the comment that when I was reading these, I
I feel like the Essex Town School District, this particular version of it is so much more readable and understandable to the layperson.
Well, there was that dimension, the structure of the document as well as the content, so.
Yeah, that's just from my perspective.
Yeah, I found the research that David did was enlightening.
Right.
In terms of.
Yeah, and
maybe another view on how to do these, that kind of thing, perhaps better.
We as a district have been working on job description revision update, and Karen Dancher's been instrumental in that. So formatting and clarity has been a really big part of that. And this has been absent. Your job description has been absent of that, essential functions of the job. I mean, I don't mean it. Obviously, you have duties and responsibilities, but we
No, I read it at the last meeting. I didn't know what it said.
Yeah. So I what I would encourage, I understand Dan and Martin, and I would put Karen in touch with you. I'm not that I'm backing out totally, but she'll work up a format for you, and I'll talk to her tomorrow and get you going, maybe with a shared document where you can populate some of these things, and she'll start to work with you on that, if that would work. So
to broaden this just a little bit to give everybody an opportunity to weigh in advance, if anybody has an idea of something you think that we do as board members that is not reflected here, to send it to David and Karen, and then she can maybe take the first pass at it, and then Dan and I can pick it up from there.
Great, thank you.
All right. And did you want to specifically get a date?
You can move to that next one.
Okay.
Which is right on the, we've got the special meeting August 4th. Oh,
well,
no,
I'm sorry. I'm talking
no,
about the
right.
work meeting.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
We set that for the 31st of August. That was something different.
There's one set.
It's the three-hour work session.
I don't know.
Yeah, I think this may be set. So why don't we just confirm that we have that work?
Yeah, I think you, Delinus.
Yeah, all right.
Okay.
5 o'clock
on
the
31st.
Okay, yeah. So all we right. do have that work session, and now we have at least one agenda item, which
will
be the board
forward.
Job description.
Yep.
Did we talk about what other work we wanted to do at that extended session?
We may have, but I didn't bring the notes from the last time that we talked about that. So I'm sure we have it in the minutes, probably. I'm not recalling.
We talked about setting the time. I don't think we talked about
content. Was there anything that's top of mind for the board right now that we'd want to include in a work session? Which, just as a refresher, these particular sessions either reflect an opportunity to take items off future agenda items, or allow for more in-depth discussion on topics that have some depth to them that we can't do in a regular session.
Sort of a question of understanding. I see in front of us a fairly intensive task in trying to wrestle with the visioning possibilities. Mm-hmm. Is our thinking that we're going to try to do that in the context of our regular meetings, or is this going to be a parallel flow of other sessions, especially when it comes to community feedback kind of things? If, to have something meaningful could use up the whole block of time that we have set for a regular meeting. So. And I asked that in the context of, to me, visioning ought to be part of this if it's going to be part of our normal work stuff. If it's going to be a separate thing, then perhaps not.
See, what I think, I'm going to be a little bit funny for a minute. I think you revised your board job description to say you're the next followers of the task force. So the board, you know. I think you're right, Dan. I mean, I do think that the master planning, or, you know, kind of the configuration, the decisions of where we are is going to be.
Yeah, I don't think we get to nominate it. Personally, I don't think we get to nominate a task force again to go do the work for us.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
as you bring
that up, that is my recollection now that was the major content of the working session. So actually, that's a good combo right there, is board job description with next steps and work plan. Although I think we'll have some interim discussions on master planning based on what we directed mm-hmm. David to kind of bring back in terms of timing and collaboration with the city and so forth. So if the board is agreeable, those will basically be the two topics.
Yeah, and I think those are really good, because as you start talking about the board's job description, and then you put in front of yourself the visioning work, that's going to feed back into that job description really nicely.
And just for clarity for the community and the public, this is an open session. This is not an executive session, unless we declare some item as we're the fact that we're meeting ahead of time. But this would be an open working session on those topics then. So we'll get that agenda out and warn it as appropriate. Okay. All right, so we can, unless there's any other questions on that or comments, we can move to agenda item 12, setting the agenda for a special meeting on August 4th and a regular meeting on August 19th.
Yeah, so August 4th, again, was allocated primarily when we talked last time for new hires.
Mm-hmm.
But I also know that we need to add, act on the RFP for legal services, mm-hmm. Which would be the only addition so far to the August 4th, would be my recommendation to you.
And we need the tax anticipation note?
Yes.
Okay. Yep. And this is a telephonic meeting, correct?
We set it up that way because I think it was difficult. People were all over. Obviously, whoever can come here is fine. Whoever can't, we can pull as many people into the meeting as possible. We'll hold it still as a public meeting. So if you're on the phone, you'll be, you know, on the speaker. I'll be in a designated warned location. So
if the public wanted to participate, we would have the, like a speakerphone in this facility, for instance, or somewhere.
That's exactly right.
All right. Okay, anything else for the August 4th?
And you're going to get information on how to call in if we are.
Yeah, either we'll use our own conference methodology, or I'll do a go-to meeting or something like that for you.
Okay, so we'll move to the proposed agenda for August 19th. We can take 10 off. Yeah. We'll move it to the special meeting. Or the work meeting, sorry.
Yeah.
Anything else for the 19th?
I'm going to probably join that one by phone.
Okay.
Okay.
I think I'll be
Master planning and visioning. I mean, I suggest we keep it on there, just so whatever we have for updates is, I know people may think it's redundant, but we've been able to give updates on that pretty
well. And that may be one after our work session on the 31st. We could make a decision on how it shows up.
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right, so we'll move on to future agenda items. Any comments or questions? Looks like everything has a date on it.
Mm-hmm.
Do we have monitoring report 2.2 on an August agenda?
Second meeting in August, I believe, is when we're trying to do that one.
I know we've deferred this until after the final task force report, but I just want to continually remind people that we do need to get visioning on here because it is a big task.
Oh, on the future meetings, you mean? Just identifying it?
I mean, I think we all know it's there, but...
Yeah, I got you.
Yeah.
Just so it's...
So the two performance evaluation topics show up in monitoring report 2.2, which is on the 19th agenda.
Yeah.
Although these are specific subjects under that monitoring report.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Okay.
That is the second meeting.
Nothing else on future agenda items? So we'll move to agenda item 14, consider the minutes of the meeting of July 8th. Any comments or changes to those minutes? Seeing none, those are approved. And we'll move to the consent agenda.
So on the consent agenda, you have two hires, a 0.6 math teacher at the high school and a 1.0 math coach at Orchard. You also have in your packet the new hires report. one of which is slightly over the suggested budgeted and one's under. So again, some of this, particularly with specialized math coach, that's an over, and then the math teacher is a newer hire, 0.6 and 0.1. I don't know if there's any specific questions on those, but that's the highlight. I'd like to say my under over balances, but it does not. It's close, but doesn't balance. That's not the way I make those decisions either, but.
Do I have a motion to approve the consent agenda as proposed by administration?
So moved.
Just a point of order, do we usually pass, don't we usually just accept by consensus the consent agenda?
That's a good question.
You do unless you pull it off. I was just giving comment on the.
Okay.
Yeah. I mean.
Yeah, this isn't warned for action. Right. So, yeah, apologize for asking for right. that. Thank you, Dan, keeping me honest. So any questions or comments then? Seeing none, the consent agenda is approved. Any questions on agenda item 16, AP orders 1, 2, and 3? Other than noting we're back to 1, 2, and 3? All right, and we have an action item on agenda item 17, an AP order check to AAC Contracting in the amount of $74,600.
So, again, this is for asbestos abatement. John's done a nice job putting some information together for you about what that is, consistent with the work that's happening at the high school. John, anything you'd like to highlight specific to that?
When we accepted the bids on the project, Bart Maselli volunteered to be the clerk of the works. And so when this bill came through, I said this would be a good time to give a report on what actually happened. So he kept his notes here and took some, I think, the impactful pictures of what the room looked like before it was stripped out. And AAC worked on the 3rd of July, well past anybody else working. I checked in on the 4th of July, and it was a great job. Our regular contractors were able to start Monday on schedule after July 6th. So I'm thankful for that because it's a really tight time frame.
So, John, are we on schedule, and are things going? Are there any unexpected circumstances here?
We have a weekly construction meeting for a couple hours with the architects and the general construction manager and the foreman. And we're about 6 days ahead of schedule. We brought our IT people in. Unforeseen, there is a little problem. Our bathroom renovation, we're doing that small bathroom. The structural steel and the work that's there is a little tricky. That's the only place, but it's not behind or anything. It's just, if you want to know, it's a bit tricky.
Well, so. I was more interested, well, yes, I'm certainly interested in that dimension of it, but I guess where the board would certainly, at least I would certainly have some interest is, are we looking at potentially the extra costs that were unanticipated of any significance? Not at this point, okay.
No, not at all.
Okay. Any other comments, David?
No, whole thing, I really do want to publicly thank John and his staff and Martin Maselli. I mean, they actually, John's living over there, which I get him over here a little bit, but, you know, his desk doesn't have electricity. He chewed, you know, so obviously we have a space for him, but.
He's gotten a lot of extra time.
Yeah, but lot going on, and. You know, I think we've come to some really good decisions around how to move forward this size of the project. So, again, to him and his group, you know, hats off.
So do I have a motion to approve the AP order check to AAC Contracting as recommended?
Yes, I'll make that motion.
Second.
Any further discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
The motion passes.
Great, thank you.
I don't know if it's out of order or not. Tell me if it is, but since we got John talking here, I see a lot of activity with the windows project. How's that going?
That's going great. The abatement of PCBs was done on time. The work you see now is the prep work. I'm not a builder, so they're making sure every foundation, before they put the windows in, are all level and properly insulated, and all the mechanical fans are working prior to the windows going in. The windows start Monday, and it's a 3-week process. The system that Negley and Chase came up with to button up the windows with those the plywood has been great, because we've had some horrible rains. Mm-hmm. There's no birds flying in. There's no every night the building's secure. So that planning has really paid off. And every time, this little aside, every time from room to room when they put the foundation in for the windows, Negley and Chase has to saw a little bit of that covering, wood covering, off to make it fit again. So it's a lot. It's kind of intensive, but I feel comfortable we're secure and making the right progress. So
good.
Thanks, Dan, for asking. Good. I'll take a motion to adjourn our regular meeting, and we'll reconvene for a brief executive session.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor? And we are adjourned.